So what we're going to do is get a little bit of practicing multiple numbers together, and we're going to discover some things. So first, I want you to figure out what 4 times 5 times 2 is. Pause the video and try to figure it out on your own. All right, so whatever your answer is, some of you might have done it this way. Some of you might have said, hey, what is 4 times 5? And then you multiplied it by 2. So what you would really have done is, you would have done 4 times 5 first, that's why I put parentheses around that, and then you would have multiplied by 2. And what would you have gotten? Well, the 4 times 5 part, that is of course 20, and then you multiply that times 2, and you would get 40, which of course would be correct. 4 times 5 times 2 is indeed equal to 40. Now what I want you to do now is, as quickly as possible, try to figure out what 5 times 2 times 4 is. Really quick, pause the video, try to figure that out. Well, some of you might have tried, and you might have done it in a similar way, where you tried to figure out what 5 times 2 is first, and you said, okay, 5 times 2 is equal to 10, and then I'd multiply that times 4, and then you would say, well, gee, this is the same thing as I got last time. Is there something interesting going on? And the interesting thing that you might realize is, in both cases, we're multiplying the same 3 numbers. We are just doing it in a different order. Here we multiplied 4 times, we wrote it out in a different order, 4 times 5 times 2. Here we wrote 5 times 2 times 4. Here we did the 4 times 5 first. Here we did the 5 times 2 first. But notice, we got the same result. And I encourage you, pause this video, try to multiply these numbers in any order. Maybe you do 2 times, maybe you do 2 times 4 first. In fact, let's just do that. Let's do 2 times 4, and then multiply that by 5. What is this going to be equal to? Well, you might notice again, this is 2 times 4 is 8. You multiply that times 5. Well, once again, we got 40. So you might see a pattern here. It doesn't matter which order we multiply these things in. In fact, you could write 4 times 5 times 2. You could do the 4 times 5 first, 4 times 5 times 2, or you could do 4 times 5 times 2. So you could do 4 times 5 times 2. So it doesn't matter which order you multiply these things in. In every case, you are going to get 40. Now, there's a very fancy term for this, the associative property of multiplication. But the main realization is, and it's not just true with 3 numbers. In fact, you've seen something similar with 2 numbers, where it doesn't matter what order you multiply them in. But what you see is with 3 numbers, and even if you tried it with 4 or 5, or really a 1,000 numbers being multiplied together, as long as you're just multiplying them all, it doesn't matter what order you're doing it with. And it doesn't matter in what order you associate them with. Here we did 4 times 5 first. 4 times 5 first. Here we did 5 times 2 first. But in either case, we got the same result. And I encourage you, after this video, try to draw it out. Try to think about why that actually makes intuitive sense, why this is true in the world. And it's nice because it simplifies our life when we're doing mathematics, not only now, but in our future mathematical career.